Graceless, tarnished. What is thy business with these thrones? Ah, Godrick the Golden. The twin prodigies, Mikala and Melania. General Radahn. Praetor Rykard. Luna Princess Rani. Willful traitors, all. Thy kind are all of a piece. Pillagers, emboldened by the flame of ambition. Have it writ upon thy meager grave. Felled by King Morgoth, last of all kings. We'll be right back. forgiven. Tarnished. Thou'rt but a fool. The Erd Tree wards off all who deign approach. We are all forsaken. None may claim the title of Elden Lord. Thy deeds shall be met with failure, just as I.
Hello again, old friend. Allow me a moment to converse with you. You were unable to enter the Erd Tree, no? Prevented by the mantle of barbs. The thorns are impenetrable, a husk of the Erd Tree's being that spurns all that exists without. The only way to stand before the Elden Ring and become the Elden Lord is to pass the thorns. My purpose serves to aid in that very act. So I'd like you to undertake a new journey with me to the Flame of Ruin, far above the clouds, upon the snowy mountaintops of the giants. Then I can set the Erd Tree aflame and guide you down the path to becoming Elden Lord. I wish to journey with you once more to the Flame of Ruin, far above then, and guide you.
You found the unalloyed gold needle. As promised, I've detailed the secret of Celia right here. Go on. It's yours. Now let me have a look at the needle. Well, this is a marvel indeed. The work of a true artisan, a meticulous, bold craftsman who grasps the essence of life. Can you give me some time with this? As well made as it is, it won't be much use snapped in half, will it? Can you give me some time? As well made as it is, it won't be much use. I have awaited your return. The needle is repaired. Now it will forestall the rotting sickness, I'm sure. Will you give it to the girl, Millicent? I will reward you in kind. Millicent rests at the church atop the cliff beyond Celia, the town yonder. attended to by the witless pests who worship her, or rather her rotting sickness, as a god. A wretched fate, indeed. The poor girl, she never wished for any of this. Do you find it peculiar that I would show such concern for the girl? Well, I'm the one that found her. A mere babe in the swamp of Aeonia. She is one of my dear daughters. But the rotting sickness erodes one's memory. I doubt that she remembers the first thing about me. Oh, I must be getting old. I didn't always worry so much. Now, all you need to do is deliver the needle to me. She's convalescing. Do so.
If you are wise, you will leave immediately. My flesh writhes with scarlet rot. You ask that I stab myself with the needle to quell the scarlet rot. But how? Never mind. I've decided I would rather trust you than simply continue to spoil from within. Would you mind averting your eyes for a moment? Well, that was easier than expected. But why do I feel so...
Thank you kindly for giving the needle to Millicent. Now she too can begin her journey and stare her fate straight in the eye. You've been a saint through and through. As thanks, I vow to impart to you my knowledge of the lost sorceries of the Salians, descendants of the Eternal. Please make certain that little Millicent goes unharmed. Like her mother, she has the stuff to be a great warrior, but commands only one arm and is yet preciously young. Do you need me for something else?
I hoped to see you again. My apologies for when last we met. I fainted before I could even thank you. Everything is as you said. Since inserting the needle, the scarlet rot has ceased to writhe. Even the nightmares have abated. And now, though I can scarcely believe it myself, I can move as I please. Not that I could ever truly repay you. But I would like you to have this, by way of thanks. A token though it is. I'm considering leaving. On a journey, with the needle buried in my flesh, I've started to recall, but dimly, my destiny. It's all thanks to you. My name is Millicent. I pray fate permits us meet again. I'm considering leaving, with the needle buried in my flesh, my destiny.
again. Something about this place felt familiar to me, so I decided to pay a visit, hoping to find someone here, but I've only found emptiness. Perhaps before my departure, I needed someone to say farewell to. Well, never mind that. I must focus on my journey, for which I have you to thank. I must stay strong. Well, I must focus on my journey. I must stay.
Ah, welcome, welcome. How may I help? Oh, you noticed, did you? Indeed, Millicent did visit this hovel of a home. It seems the memories eaten away by the rotting sickness yet remain, but faintly. However, she has no need of me anymore. No, she must embark on her journey and stare her fate in the eye. I mustn't impede. As I've aged, I've found the best way to aid the young is to be forgotten. Do you need me for something else?
To return. You know what this means. The Earth Tree has burned you. The fingers remain still. Shaken by this turn of events, they are busy consulting the Crater Will. When they are finished, the fingers will again offer their guidance. But thousands, if not tens of thousands, of moons must first pass. No matter for me, but you. How will you ever manage to wait? My, oh my. Heavens forbid. That is not the domain of mere men. The burning of the Earth Tree is the first cardinal sin. And you say you seek the power of the Rune of Death too? The Rune of Death goes by two names. The other is Destined Death. The forbidden shadow plucked from the Golden Order upon its creation. Unleashing the Rune now would be unthinkable. The fingers would never permit it. Nor would the Greater Will. But here we are. The fingers dormant, severing our link to the Greater Will. The realm and all life in ruins. Impossible events transpire. Beyond the ken of the fingers, who is to say that the cardinal sin must be cardinal forever? Go on. Finish the job. Take the course you deem most worthy. You must find kindling. Only the smoldering flame in the great forge of the giants on the highest peak in the lands between can burn the Earth Tree. But special kindling is required to reignite the flame. For the flame to burn the Earth Tree, a sacrifice is needed. Of one who envisions the flame. And can lead you to the Rune of Death.
get me out of here.
Must eat more. Defile more. Everything that matters to you. For generations to come. I am the Dung Eater. A scourge upon the living. Who are you? I've been here long enough. I will kill again. And defile each corpse with care. Just to be sure that when they're reborn, they'll be cursed. Along with their children. And their children's children. For all time to come. I will kill again. Just to be sure that when they're in, they'll be cursed. Just to be sure he'll be good.
Think not of the kindling. I shall see to that. All I ask of you is to make the journey to the snowy mountaintops of the giants, far above the clouds. I know I'm asking you to commit a cardinal sin, but it must be done to reach the path beyond. And that is the path I wish to travel. What is your mind? If you intend to claim the frenzied flame, I ask that you cease. It is not to be meddled with. It is chaos, devouring life and thought unending. However ruined this world has become, however mired in torment and despair, life endures. Births continue. There is beauty in that. Is there not? If you would become Lord, do not deny this notion. Please, leave the frenzied flame alone. The frenzied flame is not to be meddled with. It is chaos, devouring life and thought unending. So please, leave the frenzied flame alone. The frenzied flame, it is chaos, so please.